ministry, it will not ever be obsolete. It's always going to be needed.
The large college campus is a great experience, I think, in many ways, but it's very unrealistic.
I think that it's important that a college not only exists to train young people, but then when they graduate, actually go out and do what they were trained to do, as opposed to just vegetate for the next 4, 5, 6, 7, or 10 years and say, I wonder what God wants me to do.
It's not just an academic pursuit. If that's all we have, we very quickly become dry.
You know, there are people who go to computer schools in 4 years, and then 4 years later, their computer knowledge is obsolete.
A lot of times the kids are just shell-shocked when they get out of college and enter the real world, so to speak.
Yeah, I guess I'd illustrate it by saying, like, if you've read the DMV manual, but you've never driven, I don't want to ride with you.
No one wants to go to college for 4 years and afterwards feel like they were not really trained. You want to come out of any training experience feeling confident and ready. The best way to do this is to train with people who are doing what you aspire to do. There's nothing like being taught by experts, by those who are having success where you want to have success. God is calling many into ministry, and we want them to have success. They don't want to just sit in a classroom for their training, because ministry is nothing like that. Our heart at Pacific Baptist College is to train tomorrow's ministry leaders today.
The setup we have is similar to the philosophy of training doctors. Really, when they go to college and they graduate from med school, it's frightening how little they know. Really, where they learn is in their residency program, talking to doctors. And they're many times following the doctors around in a group of 4, 5, 2. Now that's our school. It's this small group talking to one expert, so to speak. And that is the way the doctors learn best. And they learn most of their skills in the residency years. Well, our students are getting their college education and residency all at once. So it's a very unique combination.
Be around men of God and women of God who are serving, who are being faithful. You know, open up God's word and see them living what they were talking about, you know, practicing what they preached, and you see in their lives, you hear the testimonies about their churches, people being baptized and saved. It was a challenge. We would sit and talk after class. I remember we'd stay hours sometimes after class just talking about philosophy or what they are doing at their church and why they did what they did. You know, what I learned throughout the week, I'd practice it on Sunday, and so it gave me an opportunity to, put into practice what I was being taught throughout the week, and I would see the results of it, and I'd, man, this is really working. It feels really practical, and I love practicality because that's something I could take home and use right away.
The best thing about Pacific Baptist College is the teacher relationship. I am the type of person who asks a lot of questions, but having that desire to be with someone in ministry already, who's already doing the work, who's already part of bigger things, you can learn a lot. You know, Jesus had his 12, and he spent most of his time with his 12. And of course he did all the other things. He had 5,000 and he reached a lot of people, but most of his time and the lessons that he taught were with the 12. Like, there are many people who followed him, but he picked 12. Peter, James, and John, they all made mistakes. They all made mistakes. But Jesus stayed with them and taught them. And these 12 ended up doing great things. The Bible says they turned the world upside down.
I've been to, you know, secular university, and there's just, you don't have a relationship with your teacher. The pastors and other educators that come in, they actually talk to you and get to know you, get to know about you, where you come from, things like that. And that builds more of a rapport, builds more of a bond with the teachers.
Because we're a smaller college, it allows those pastors to have real intimate moments with those students, in the sense that they can take a little more time with them, answer more questions, probably with more time than most colleges would allow.
We're not so big that students get lost in the crowd, that they become a number. Nobody falls through the cracks. Everybody knows everybody. It becomes a big extended family.
As teachers and staff members, and they go through crazy amount of trials in their life, and they're so dedicated to us and wanting to help us and loving us, loving on us, and it's tremendous to see.
They have a heart to really take students under their wing because they're not overwhelmed with 150. They can do that.
What I saw, which I could see because it was so small, was Bible character, like biblical character. Like anyone really could get a syllabus and spit out knowledge. But does that affect you somehow, some way? Maybe not. I'm not going to say it isn't. But the character of each teacher here, it motivated you to do so many things. My teachers, who are someone I look up to, and the way I speak, the way I study, the way I learn, was based off of, you know, seeing their fruit, seeing their character. And I don't know if I could have got that anywhere else.
Ministry, it is eternal. It's laying treasures up in heaven that will not destroy, that will not be corrupt, that will not be stolen from us. And so the things that in Bible college that a student learns is something that's precious. I took it as about a four-year discipleship program, if you would.
Pacific. The tests were hard, obviously, and the homework was tough, but they said, here are the tools to feed yourself spiritually. And you know, a lot of places probably would want you to know all the trivia, but this place taught me to know how to find, know how to search. Because there's gonna be times where, you know, helping someone out spiritually, trivia doesn't help.
We're big on training young people to reach this generation, the postmodern generation, Generation X, Generation Y, you know, what the millennial generation, all the different names, but basically we're dealing with a skeptical generation that questions everything. They scorn truth. They believe there's no absolute truth. They believe in moral relativism. And so we want to equip students to be able to live and work and minister in that world, whether they're in full-time ministry or not.
Not just enough to say I believe something, but can you back up what you believe with the Bible? And that's one thing I think it definitely helps you, is teaches you, is challenges you to know your Bible, because there are going to be scoffers who come, there's some people who come and challenge you, and if you don't know your Bible, anything you stand on, you're not gonna make it long term.
This has really helped me kind of ground myself in what I believe and who I am, really. And it's just been a huge encouragement being here, and the teachers and the staff, their dedication, the love they show, the personal sacrifices they've made, not just for every student, but for me, knowing that has helped me and encouraged me to keep pushing forward.
It's not a place you're gonna go. There's not a sports program. There's not the fancy things you would have at other colleges, other universities. But what it is a chance to go there and see what real life ministry is like then and right at the moment. And your first day you walk into campus, you're talking to pastors who are in the work, you're talking to missionaries who are in the work, talking to other Bible college students who are teaching classes. And so it's a right away, get involved, get serious, buckle down, let's learn, let's do this together. And so because of that atmosphere, you create good friendships with other people who are going out to do the same thing as you, and you want to help them, you want to encourage them, they talk about classes, you talk about what they did in their class on Sunday, what you did in your Sunday, how it worked, how it meshed, and you get a chance to share with them. And during those times, you share burdens together, you cry together, you share joys together. And I remember good times we had prayer meetings late at night, and we'd all get together sometimes, and some of us men, and pray for the college, pray for burdens we had, and we'd all get together and sing songs of praise together. So it's something neat. We still text each other today. We'll contact each other, text or email, ask how we're doing, and talk about our ministries, and it's something I definitely cherish.
Well, it's a serious responsibility, and it's a great privilege. We thoroughly enjoy working with young people and training them and seeing them go out and make something of their lives and do the best they can, be the best they can for God. And so it's a joy for us to be involved in that way.
Every Christian is called into ministry, and it's our privilege to invest into a select few every year to help them in this purpose. We'd love to hear from you if you are interested in applying for our next school year. You can call us anytime or go to our website to learn more. We would call it an honor to help you train today for tomorrow's ministry.